they most like to hear parting words of wisdom in the form of a baccalaureate address on this evening. And truly, in democratic fashion, every student is a vote selecting a baccalaureate speaker. Tonight's speaker comes to us with a celebrity pedigree, having been born in the same hospital as rapper DMX. And Aerosmith from Dance New Tyler. Known in high school for excelling in football, wrestling, and track, our speaker also graced the stage of his high school drama program. Basically, what I'm saying is, okay, sounds good.
Woo!
Speaker boasts many strengths, having received his high school's Ironman Award for a combined power lift total of over 1,000 pounds on the squat, deadlift, and bench press combined. And this speaker also holds the school bench press record for Hanover College in Indiana. A combination of brawn and brains, our speaker graduated magna cum laude from UMass Boston and followed a family tradition of educators beginning his own career in education. Y2K. Our speaker cited both Florida and New York before bringing his talents to the West Coast. And in between teaching, our speaker proved to be a true jack of all trades when, in December 2005, he sold more Lincoln Navigators than any other car salesman. And was pressed with good fortune to welcome an actor, musician, author, and filmmaker to our ranks. And introducing him to the fact that it was easy enough, we simply rewatched the episode of TLC's The Singing Office, during which as a member of the Grand Championship winning team. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the
And on the ninth year, the Lord said, "Let there be day." Now, I have known it as simple as just to cut my hair. I may have considered doing it years ago. But I stand here before you completely honored and humbled as you are about to take flight in your next journey in life. You asked me, Edward and I, to send you off with words of wisdom that you will remember for the rest of your lives. Well, true story. When I was in high school at St. Thomas in Fort Lauderdale, I used to wear my wisdom tooth around my neck. Recently, I found that tooth again after 20 years and have chosen to wear it once again for all of you. Get your wisdom back, and pass it on. And in doing so, I will concentrate on three aspects of life that I feel are extremely important. First, connection between inspiration and creativity. Second, choices we all make as individuals. And finally, how to find God in all that you do. God is the ultimate creator. God is within each one of us, which makes us all creators as well. Creativity crosses all boundaries and is needed in every aspect of life. Every 7 years, our DNA changes and we become new individuals who have the power of thought, analysis, and execution. The world is filled with people and things, and people create variables to progress as individuals. So be part of this web of humanity that is divinely intertwined, and be part of humanity that creates. Create good wherever you are, and watch how your life will change for the better. Use the through the Spirit to help you make decisions in your life that will benefit you and your community. Being a creative thinker occurs when you allow divine inspiration to come into your life. Be still. Breathe deep. Become present with everything around you. That is God's presence. Creativity can link certain things together that seem like there may be no place for it. The Creative Spirit guides us to manifest our thoughts, our ideas, and expands our minds. With good intentions at the core of your heart, stand tall and firm in your beliefs. Take from the things that work for you and implement them into your lives. We came into this world naked and alone, and we will leave this earth the same way. So make sure you leave your creative footprint on society. Think outside the box, problem solve, come up with the best scenario, and manifest that situation in your life. These things are maximized when utilizing the Creative Spirit. One thought I would like to leave you with concerning creativity is this. Pope John Paul II said, "Artistic talent is a gift from God, and whoever discovers it in himself has a certain obligation to know that he cannot waste his talent, but must develop it." How can this statement help shape you guys as individuals using creativity as its source? Second, when making decisions in your life, decide to pursue your craft, whatever that may be, and do it every day, and do it well. Whether you decide to pursue law, the medical field, the arts, education, military, wherever your destiny leads you, through the decisions you make, remember to always keep the Holy Spirit in the forefront of your thought, in your heart, and in your mind. Life is not easy, and we are here to serve others, as God was made in flesh and served us. Live your life accepting responsibility for your actions. Stand in the face of evil. Never fear. Because you stand with the one who conquered death. You will learn to live life as each day is your last. Helping others, giving and receiving, and finding that balance. Making each day count as you continue to set goals and work at achieving them each day will help develop you into the man God intended you to be. Your decisions should have unity, structure, inspiration. These are the things that keep you going in life. St. Therese, the Little Flower, teaches us that we make choices every day that contribute to or take away from our capacity of greatness. Remember that as you live your life, know you can bring nothing with you into heaven except your love. So make each day count. From the ashes of disaster, rise the roses of success. The deeper the suffering, the greater the sacrifice. Some may say to you, run from these things. I say, embrace these things. Carry your crosses and do it with a smile. When you choose to do good, do not gloat about it. Just move on to the next good thing that you can do. If you continue to give, God will provide means for you to continue sharing blessings in other people's lives. So choose to be good. Choose to love instead of hate. Choose to show respect rather than demoralize. Choose to encourage and enhance compared to tearing down. Choose to forgive those who hurt you. There is great power in the humble spirit. Choose to sing every moment of your life and use your creativity to problem solve and to intertwine all these aspects of your life. Will you stumble and fall? Yes, of course, we all do. But that is what makes our life path so unique, so special between ourselves and our Creator. Each and every one of you have the opportunity to make a difference in this world. No matter where your life leads you, you all have these 4 years in common. So appreciate and nurture these relationships that took you from adolescence and transformed you into the crusty men you are today. God makes you the best version of yourself. He is vested, He created you. We are all created to be saints. So put God first, no matter what. Approach life with the innocence of a child, but use your experiences to permeate the gospel into your lives. We must keep our souls aligned with God and call on His healing power to guide our steps as we encounter trials and errors, and even fall. But get back up again. Just remember, Christ always has His hand extended, waiting to lift us back to our feet. And I believe you are all storytellers. Christ told the ultimate story. Let your accomplishments be your legacy. What is your story? How will others perceive you when you are no longer in their lives? We are all here because God has called us to help shape, educate, live by example, and develop His chosen people, which are all of us. We are all special in God's eyes. We are all His children. When you have children of your own, you will understand that deep, perpetual, unconditional love that never ceases. Enjoy this time of transition. Because before you know it, you will have already graduated college, started an occupation, and hopefully found the love of your life. In conclusion, I am grateful that all of you have chosen me to speak to you today. I want to thank you for the beautiful memories that we shared these past 4 years. I love you, and I will always be here for you. And I pray you God's all these blessings upon you. May He forever guide, bless, and protect you all. And when you leave here this evening, please allow my question to ring over in your mind. What is your story? Thank you again. God bless the graduating class of 2017.